when things start running.
Not very far away, there lived a rich but aged man whose hair was turning gray. He had three sons, three only ones, both Jack and Tom were sly, but Ted was honest as could be. He would not tell a lie. The brothers tried to ruin Ted before the old man's eyes. At last their plot began its work, till Ted was much despised. Then the father said, "Be gone, you're heartless to the core." And the black sheep's words, they came just ringing through the door. "Don't be angry with me, Dad. Don't drive me from your door. I know that I've been wayward. I repeat it o'er and o'er. Please give me one more chance, then put me to the test. You'll find a black sheep who loves his dad far better than the rest." Now year by year sped quickly by, the father now grown old. He called to them, both Jack and Tom, and gave them all his gold. "I only want a little room, a place by your fireside. One night on Jack's returning home, he brought with him a bride." The three began to hate the father more and more each day, until at last they heard him say, "What are you old fools in our way?" They then agreed to send him to the poorhouse that was near. And the black sheep's words, they came just ringing in his ear. A wagon drives up to the house, it is the poorhouse van. The brothers pointed to their dad and said, "Right there's your man." But then the manly form appeared, came rushing through the crowd. "Stop this, you fools," the lad replied, "it shall not be allowed. You took the old man's property and all that he could save. You even sold the little lot containing mother's grave. I am his son, but not your kin, from now till judgment day." The father claps the black sheep's hand, and they all heard him say, "Don't be angry with me, son. I know I drove you from my door. I know that I was foolish, lad. I repeat it o'er and o'er. I should have given you my gold, for you have stood the test. I found the black sheep who loves his dad far better than the rest.
Good night, everyone. Welcome to another Herman Harrison Friend Show. That opening number was in memory of Brother Larry Nosworthy and Mother Jean Nosworthy, requested by Bernice Nosworthy. And it's also for Bill Coyley and all his friends up in Toronto, and for Dan Neville up in North River. And now we're going to do one entitled Yellow Roses, one from Hank Snow. And this one is for Herman Butt down at the Harmer Lodge, George and Phyllis Mercer, Jess and Geraldine Mercer, Gordon and Mrs. Peckham down in Savin Cove, George and Lillian Homer, Jim and Shirley Parsons, Mike and Barb Quinlan, and Art and Joan Thomas down in Carbonear. Yellow Roses, this is an old timer, wait a minute.
I just received, sweetheart, your yellow roses. You tell me, dear, they mean that we're all through. You tell me that tonight your heart is broken, but you should know I was never untrue. I'll place them near your photograph, and as the petals fall, they'll hide from you my lonely tears that shouldn't fall at all. Then they will slowly fade away and die, but I'll still love you, though yellow roses say goodbye. And they will slowly fade away and die, but I'll still love you, oh yellow roses, say goodbye.
Now we're going to do one that I don't think we ever done on the show before, and this one is entitled The Young Fisherwoman. This is a song that was recorded by Smiley Bates, and it's for Maureen and Lloyd Higdon over in Greens Harbor, for Gordon and Ida Skinner down in Bristol's Hope, Yvonne Shepherd, Nelson and Stell Taylor, and Chess and Edith Poy. The Young Fisherwoman. This is a bit of a sad song, although it was done by Smiley Bates up in Ontario. I got a fair amount of Newfoundland flair to it, you know.
The boats were all set to depart. The crews prepared nets for the journey. One last kiss from sweethearts and wives who were left standing there by the sea. One young wife with tears in her eyes, who had only a short time been wed, had promised a way to return of her husband, the fisherman man. She watched the small boat with its sail, just a speck on the distant horizon. She then turned a weary foot home, for she knew that the night would soon come. How empty the village would be, how lonely the fisherman's life. For this was Ned's first trip to sea, since she moved to the village his wife. 12 days had passed since they'd gone. It was time for return to the harbor. The women and children were there,
when laughter and hearts all aglow. And some there were cries of delight from the lips of the ones that had gathered. Small tiny white sails had been seen. They were welcome and hailed as they neared. But then came a cry of despair from the side of the boats they'd been yearning. They all knew that 15 had left, but only 14 had returned. Poor Grace, so torn, could not speak. It was Ned's boat that could not be found. The others trod sad to their home, while Grace knelt there on the ground. The story was told off the wind in the storm, how this one boat was swaying, how men were all lost in the night. Then the whole village silently wept. The villagers tell how for years the young fisherwoman did cry and wait for the boats to come in each night by the lonely seaside. And now we got to do one entitled Danny Boy, and I don't think we done this one before either.
No, so they better.
A little bit out of our league, but we're going to try it anyway. And it's for Welford Riggs down in Bay de Verde, and happy birthday to Jenny Bursey on July the 17th, and that comes from brother William Mills down in Old Perlican. For Mike and Marg Woodford, Dick and Mar Slowis, Duncan Daphne Blondin, and also happy 65th birthday to Dunk.
Duncan Blondin.
Happy birthday, Dunk boy.
He's a sweetheart.
Oh, yeah. You got to be careful calling them men sweethearts. It's all right for me to call the women sweethearts, but you're making a habit calling all these men sweethearts. Next thing, I'm going to lose you. Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the flowers are dying. It's you must go, and I must buy. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. Yes, I'll be there in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. But when you come and all the flowers are dying, if I am dead, as dead I well may be, you'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an ave there for me. And I shall hear those soft you tread above me, and all my grave will warm and sweeter be, for you will bend and tell me that you love me, and I shall sleep in peace peace until you come to me. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so.
That's our version of it.
Anyway, now we're going to do music and friends, and this one is for Anne and Mary Toomey up in Woodford's Comfort Manor, and for all the other residents at Woodford's Comfort Manor, for Edna Doyle and her friends down in Gull Island, Jim and June Noserly in Harbour Grace, Hetty Tarrant and Bessie Andrews, Anna Fiore down in Carbonear, Peg Pye, Effie Hobbs, Bob and Phyllis Forward, Catherine Crawford, Carmel George, and all the other St. Pat Seniors. Crowd, if we left someone out, so we'd say everybody, and that should cover everyone.
I've done a lot of living, and I found that no matter where you go, the whole world round, they always go together, hand in hand. Where there's one, there'll be the other, music and friends. When blue sky turn to gray and hide the sun, when tired hands their daily work has done, nothing seems to turn things round again and make the whole world right like music and friends. Music and friends, it's so good to bring together music and friends. Side by side, no one can break them if you take the time to make them. Nothing else can take the place of music and friends. Music and friends, it's so good to bring together music and friends. Side by side, no one can break them if you take the time to make them. Nothing else can take the place of music and friends. Where there's one, there'll be the other, music and friends.
Now we got to do Saltwater Joys, and this one is for Annie Hogan down Northern Bay, and requested by Pius, that's her son, I guess. And
Pius.
And she's 82 years old. And it's also for Irene Davin and Dennis Davin in Upper Island Cove, for Mabel Spurl, for Joan Lang, Molly Lang, Dat Davis, Audrey Butt, Mildred Diamond down in Adams Cove. And she's an old lady we met down at Fong's the other night.
She's not an old lady, she's a young lady.
And she's she recognizes us from the television.
She's 90.
And we had a nice chat with her.
90 years old, I think, yeah.
Then we found out that she knew your mom years ago.
She's a sweet person.
She's a lovely lady, yeah.
Lovely lady.
Anyway, we're going to do Saltwater Joys.
Just to wake up in the morning to the quiet of the cold, and to hear Aunt Bessie talking to herself, and to hear poor Uncle John mumbling wishes to old Nell, it made me feel like everything was fine. I was born down by the water, and it's here I'm going to stay. I search for all the reasons why I should go away, but I haven't got the terse for all those modern day toys, so I'll stay, take my chances with those saltwater joys. Following a little brook as it trickles to the shore in the autumn when the trees are flaming red, kicking leaves that fall around me, watch the sunset paint the hills, that's all I'll ever need to feel at home.
Some go to where the buildings reach to touch the clouds, where warm and gentle people turn to swarm and faceless crowds. So I'll do without their riches, the glamour and the noise, and I'll stay, take my chances with those saltwater joys. How can I leave those mornings with the sunrise on the cove and the gulls like flies surrounding Clayton's Wharf? Platter's Island wrapped in rainbow in the evening after fog, and the ocean smells a perfume to my soul. Some go to where the buildings reach to touch the clouds, where warm and gentle people turn to swarm and faceless crowds. So I'll compliment her beauty, hold on to my goodbyes, and I'll stay, take my chances with those saltwater joys. I'll stay and take my chances with those saltwater joys. Now we got to do the Newfie Stomp, and this one is for Gordon Burns. Down in Old Perlican, as requested by his grandmother, Minnie Squires in Old Perlican, and it's for Jonathan Daw here in Bay Roberts, for Ricky Walsh, and he's up in Cubas, Graham Drover over in Blaketown, Amanda Butt down in Carbonear, and Clyde Drover in Victoria, Caroline and Providence Budden in Whitburn. And they're good friends of ours, so we're in the Newfie Stomp.
Spreading across the country like a wildfire on the run. They're picking them up and laying them down, people having fun. Now when you get your going, boys, it's gonna be hard to stop, cause everybody's doing it, they're doing the Newfie Stomp. It's stomp, 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 stomp until you drop. Yes, everybody's doing it, they're doing the Newfie Stomp. Started down in Newfoundland one cold December night, as Jenny played the squeeze box, the wind blew out the light. We got the girls out on the floor and we wouldn't let them stop. They started jumping up and down and doing the Newfie Stomp. It stomp, 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 stomp until you drop. Yes, everybody's doing it, they're doing the Newfie Stomp. They tell me up in Ottawa the government fell asleep, so Brian Tobin went up there, said, boys, now listen to me. Forget the cat and the shuffle, John, I think they had enough. Get everybody on the floor, we're doing a Newfie Stomp. It's stomp, 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 stomp until you drop. Yes, everybody's doing it, they're doing a Newfie Stomp. It's Saturday night in Bay Roberts and everyone's feeling fine. Corey's drinking down a beer and Brian is sipping wine. Alice and Bill are back again, they're giving them all they got. And Jennifer shouting from the bar, play me the Newfie Stomp. It's stomp, 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 stomp until you drop. Yes, everybody's doing it, they're doing the Newfie Stomp. It's in and out and round about and up and down again. Jump and dance and scream and shout just like a Newfie wind. Around and round and round you go until the music stops. You dance your feet right out of your boots, you're doing a Newfie Stomp. It's stomp, 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 stomp until you drop. Yes, everybody's doing it, you're doing a Newfie Stomp. Yes, everybody's doing it, you're doing a Newfie Stomp.
Now we've got the special treat for you people for this show. We're going to patch in a few songs from the Cables, and the Cables are going to be appearing with us down in Carbonear on my birthday on August the 1st down at the Princess Sheila Nagara Theatre. So we're going to bring these guys on now and let you see what they can do, and these fellas are really, really good.
Take it easy. golden hair.
Well, I tried to make it Sunday, but I got so damn depressed that I set my sights on Monday and I got myself undressed. I ain't ready for the altar, but I do agree there's times when a woman sure can be a friend of mine. Well, I keep on thinking about you, Sister Golden Hair Surprise, and I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent. I've been too hard to find, but it doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. Will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the end? Will you love me just a little, just enough to show you care? But I tried to fake it, don't mind saying I just can't make it. Doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. Will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the end? Will you love me just a little, just enough to show you care? Well, I tried to fake it, I don't mind singing, I just can't make it.
I like the way your sparkling earrings lay against your skin so brown. I want to sleep with you in the desert tonight, with a million stars all around. I may never see you again.
All right, the guy's got a little something cooked up here. Amazing Grace, blues for you.
Well, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Well, I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was so blind, oh, but now I see. It was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious is that grace of
Okay, boys, as usual, that was a wonderful job. Great job. So you people got to get out and see these fellas down at the Princess Sheila Nagara Theatre on my birthday and help me celebrate my birthday and bring a few dollars along for the daffodil place. Now we're going to do one from Merle Haggard. This one is entitled Reasons to Quit, and this one is for Jack Reynolds, Harrison Peddle, Freeman Clark at Luxury Estates, and for George and Vera Eddy and Rita Wilson up in South River.
Reason to quit. The smoke and booze don't do me like before. I'm hardly ever sober. My new friends don't come round much anymore. Reasons to quit. The lows are always lower than the highs. And the reasons to quit don't outnumber all the reasons why. And we keep smoking and we keep drinking, having fun and never thinking, laughing at the price tag that we pay. And we keep roaring down the fast lane like two young men feeling no pain.
And the reason for quitting is getting bigger each day. Reason to quit. I can't afford the habit all the time. I need to be sober, need to write some new songs that will rhyme. Reason to quit has no rhyme or reason when you're high. And the reasons to quit don't outnumber all the reasons why. And we keep smoking and we keep drinking, having fun and never thinking, laughing at the price tag that we pay. And we keep roaring down the fast lane like two young men feeling no pain. And the reason for quitting is getting bigger each day. And the reason for quitting is getting bigger each day.
Now, ma'am, have you got a... a poem for us?
Yes.
And the news bulletin, of course, as usual.
And this first poem, I got three, really, because there's one given me to Harbor Lodge that I got to get on today, but they're only small poems. And this one is for, especially for my cousin, Daphne Blunden, over in South Dillow. And I hope you're feeling better, Daphne. You're a beautiful person. And to her husband.
Two wonderful people. Duncan, Daphne, Blunden.
And this goes out to you, Daphne and Dunk. Give me the strength to meet each day with quiet will. Give me the faith to know that thou art my shepherd still. Give me the light to find my way when shadows fall. Be thou my guiding star, Father of all. That's for Daphne and Dunk. And I got one here was given to me by Herman Butt at the Harbor Lodge. Now, Herman Boy.
Herman wrote this,
and is a poem that covers everything. And he is a resident at the lodge, and this is how this goes. When daylight breaks on Saddle Hill, and the harbor comes in view, the little boats go out to fish with a brave and gallant crew. I'm writing for you Newfoundlanders already gone away. I hope come home year 2008, you will come home to stay. We have the finest hospital that you could find anywhere. We have the greatest shopping mall, Trinity Conception Square. We have the Princess Sheila Nagara Theater and West Side Charlie's too, and where you can go and have a drink and have after the day is through. We have Canadian Tire, Hickman Motors on the edge of town. If you're looking for a good car, Aiden Hibbs won't let you down. We have our share of athletes, Carbonier and Harbor Grace. When it comes to excellency, Danny Cleary wins the race. Give credit to his parents for raising such a son. He stands up for Canada and the Stanley Cup they won. To get his name on the Stanley Cup, the first one from this place, we're all there for you, Danny. You are the pride of Harbor Grace. And that's written by Herman Porter. Herman Butt. At the Harbor Lodge.
He's at the Harbor Lodge, and he wrote this recently, and you can, when you were reading this out, you could imagine him sitting, looking out through the window up at the Harbor Lodge, and this is all that he was seeing, what he was writing this poem about. That was a beautiful, beautiful job, Herman.
He's a fantastic person.
And of course, Aiden will be down to Hickman's sometime the week to pick up the check.
And I got another little poem here, and this goes out to my mom and all my St. Pat's seniors, and especially to Peggy Pye. The friendship book she gave me, I got a lot of beautiful poems in it. And it goes like this. As long as I can walk one step, I walk, dear Lord, with you. As long as I can hear one word, I listen, Lord, to you. As long as I can clasp my hands, I clasp them both in prayer. As long as I am here, dear Lord, I know that you are there. So that's another one. Now we got a few little announcements. Notes, skip and cut back, Herman boy. Come join Herman Harrison Friends for his Daffodil Place on the 73rd birthday. Jordan Beverly Oates will be there. Joe Norris leads.
Joe Norris, accordion player.
Pardon?
Joe Norris is the accordion player.
Accordion player and mouth organ player. And Junior Butt lead guitar. Beverly on the keyboard. And Hubert lead singer.
And guitar player.
And guitar player. The Cables, Corey Lawrence and Brian Dahl. Robert Parsons will be there. And Elva and Christine Harris, our two daughters from St. John's. Lots of good giveaways, door prizes, hand embroidered tablecloth, shams, and a carved loom, picture from our Tetford and Son valued at $140. Package from Alliance in St. John's, from Fong's, a donation by John and Louise Penny. A photo album from my friends in Holy Road.
Mike and Anne-Marie Gorman.
Yeah, and $10 for the ticket to get in, and all money going to the Daffodil Place. Please come out and support it, and it's a worthy cause, a good cause. And the next one is the Black Party, Southside Carbineer, starting at 2 p.m., face painting, loot bags for the children, and music, karaoke and live music. It starts in the nighttime as a dance, and karaoke and live music, like I said, is hosted by Hubert Oates and his mom, Julie. And the 17th of August is Kevin Dish Beach Festival, starting at 1:30 p.m. until sometime in the night. And you can call Leanne Cumby on that one and find out what the score is. And I think that's about it, isn't it?
Okay.
The Burgess Blueberry Festival, the 21st annual Blueberry Festival, 7, 8, 9, and 10. For a very enjoyable and exciting weekend, stop by, take in some of the activities. Traditional Newfoundland, food, music, dance, rides, games, contests, fireworks, and Emmanuel service and crafts. So the pie eating contest is fantastic up there.
You mentioned, you know, that Daphne is your cousin, but you might have also mentioned, you know, that she's formerly the Daphne Clark from Victoria, and she's the daughter of Hubert Clark. And, you know, the daughter of Hubert Clark just had to be a good person. Right?
Right.
Hubert was as good as they come, that's for sure. Okay, now we're going to do one entitled I Saw the Light. And this one is for Jim and Mabel Parsons down in Freshwater. Nellie Noel, Mary Babb, Don and Doris Russell, Ambrose and Flo Mulford, Ray and Barb MacDonald, and all the nursing homes in the area, Carbineer Hospital, the hospital down in Old Perlican, Millie George, Laura Williams over in New Harbour, Georgiana Williams at the Harbour Lodge, and Alan Williams over in New Harbour. All the Williams family are real Hank Williams fans, diehard Williams, Hank Williams fans. And of course, this is one from the pen of Hank Williams.
Yeah. Wander so aimless, life filled with sin, I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord! I saw the light, I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man I wandered alone. Sorrows and fears I claim for my own. Then like the blind man, the God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I was a fool to wander and stray. Straight is the gate and narrow's the way. Now I have traded the wrong for the right. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light.
no more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Now, I guess the only thing I got to report Marina made is the two card games.
Right, I got all the rest done.
Down at Knights of Columbus and Carbonaire, it gets underway Thursday nights at 8 p.m. They got a first, second, and third prize and a door prize. This is a great card game, and also the card game at St. James's Hall down in Carbonaire. On Monday nights, that gets underway at 8 p.m. They got a first, second, and third prize and a door prize. Both of these card games got a big attendance. They're wonderful card games, great prizes, and a must for every card player. And, of course, we got to tell everyone for sure to get out and support us down at the Princess Sheila and the Garra Theatre on August the 1st at 8 p.m. We're going to do our best to give you a real good show, and we want to collect lots of money for Daffodil Place. Remember, that's what the eye is on, Daffodil Place. So please come by and support us. We got a lot of entertainment there, a lot of prizes, and we might even give away myself and Marina for a door prize. The only thing, I got to go to a woman and she got to go to a man. Right?
Will you be satisfied for that?
Yeah, but I can always take you back.
They mightn't give me up.
Huh?
They mightn't be as easy to give up.
Oh, I'd get you back. Huh? Yes. Anyway, good night, everyone.
Good night.
And we'd like to thank the Cables, of course, for coming by there by way of film and being our special guests. It's a wonderful treat. Good night.